Juan, please come up here.
Hello. Good evening. How are you? Are you good? Good. I'm wet, but I'm good. How are you feeling today? Welcome. All right, so the power of personal responsibility. Hello, welcome. You know, I like to begin by asking a question, or typically, you know, what is personal responsibility for you? What does that mean? But I thought something came to me now, and I thought I would ask you if you believe in fate or fatalism, or I don't know how to call it. Like, do you believe in fate? Do you believe that things are set, or some things are set for you somehow? No, somehow? Somehow? What would be, like, you want to elaborate a little on that somehow? What is it for you? No. Somebody believes different. Somebody think that nothing is set in stone, and you don't believe it. Okay. Okay. So the reason why I'm asking this is because that fate, if it exists, it is. I think it will affect personal responsibility, because to what extent can I take responsibility and ownership of whatever it is in my life, if I have the idea, or if it exists, if it indeed exists, that notion of fate. This is like a done deal to whatever extent it is. So what am I going to do about it? But we'll get into that as we go on. And Manny, not working. And you can, yeah. Oh, now it's working. Thank you. So this is what we want to see today. Three basic things. First, we're just going to go over what is personal responsibility, just to get an idea of it. Understanding the power that personal responsibility has. And then, how can we overcome the obstacles that we all face when we try to exercise that personal responsibility? Taking personal responsibility, I think, to me at least, it's crucial for our growth and for our well-being, and has many, many implications. And there's research about this, and this is what triggered this talk. That there's been scientific studies that are published in different reviews about how the exercise of personal responsibility, and to what extent we do exercise that personal responsibility, is going to affect our life, it's going to affect our relationship with others, and it's going to affect even our health. There's a study published in the Journal of Personality and Social Psychology. They concluded that people who take responsibility for their actions, they tend to experience less stress, they have better mental health, and stronger interpersonal relationships. And as I say, this is just one of the different studies that I saw. again, Manny, thank you. Thanks. So what is personal responsibility? It's this notion of taking action towards the things that you need to do, and whether good or bad, you accept the consequences of those actions or the inactions that you fail to take. So the first notion is that it's something that it's up to you. It's personal responsibility. It's completely up to you to take action, to do things. It's not up to you, and maybe that's what this notion of fate or you were referring, it's not up to you, whatever comes, whatever happens, whatever, or at least not entirely up to you. Some things you may experience, and some of the things that you may experience, sometimes the way you act is how you're gonna receive things. So whatever you do, whatever energy you project, you're gonna receive that back. You were mentioning karma, or you know, that notion. Sometimes that doesn't even come from this incarnation. It may, just as an example, you may have agreed on your personal journey and your personal experience that you need to go through different experiences in order to evolve, which is, at the end of the day, what we're doing here. So maybe you made that commitment to yourself, and you find yourself maybe in a difficult material situation, or in a difficult family situation, or within difficult relationships. So to that extent, you won't be choosing that, yes. Although, you know, we could argue that, yes, it is you, it is your spirit who has chosen that situation for yourself. But you can always choose, and you will always choose how to react to that, what you do with that. And in terms of material things or material situations, you may find yourself in, you know, any of those, let's call it difficult situations, but in terms of your spirituality and in terms of your morality and in terms of your moral development, you will always, always have the ability to exercise your free will. So you can say, I'm limited by material means. I'm limited in money. I'm limited in resources. It may be. Maybe that you are in that situation. You have to work with that. But you cannot say, I'm limited in moral resources. I'm limited in spiritual resources. We all have plenty. We all have all of that. We all have full. So we can always exercise our free will on that respect, at least. This is what, if we read through the Spiritist books, this is what we find there. So personal responsibility has, it plays a very important role in our life. And a part of that is, as you see, improving relationships, self-confidence, and personal growth, taking control of my life. When I exercise that personal responsibility, that we're gonna see how we do that. When I react to whatever it is, whatever situation that it is that is happening in my life, I'm working on improving those relationships. If I leave to, let's say, have a situation where I'm working with someone. It could be here at the Spiritist Center. Maybe I'm volunteer for something, and things are not being done the way I would like them to be. Maybe they're not looking up to my standards. It's easy, and this is something we often do, to go and say, gee, I can't because, you know, this person is not doing what they're supposed to do, or they came in late, or they didn't pay attention, or they are not careful, whatever it is, whatever excuse, you know, we want to make. And we are entering into the, let's say, blame stage. And then blame is just the opposite of personal responsibility. We're going to see then later some aspects where blame is opposed to personal responsibility. But basically, to work on relationships, to work on self-confidence, on personal growth, it's very important to bear in mind how do I position myself towards all of those things, and how do I exercise my free will and my personal responsibility? Do I put the blame on others, or maybe on myself? Or do I blame external circumstances? Because if I do that, what I'm doing is I'm putting resistance into the system, into my system of growth, of personal growth, into my system of personal relationships. And that resistance, it's going to create suffering for me, but it's going to slow down my growth and difficult those relationships for me. And the consequence of that, that's going to take part of the control that I have over my own life and over my own evolution away from me. So if I want to regain control over my life and over my evolution, I should be mindful of that. I should be mindful of what comments do I make? How do I react to things? Even just the fact that I do react to things, and we have spoken about this here many times, when anything happens, what am I doing? Am I reacting? Is that helping me? How is that helping me? What kind of energy am I creating when I react to something or someone? Maybe someone making a comment. Maybe a comment that I just interpret in a specific way, which may not even be that, but I pick it up like that, and then it hurts somewhere that I don't even know, and I react to that just because it's hurting. And I think I'm when this happens, okay, when this happens to me, I typically feel like I have the right to say something, or I need to defend myself, or I'm right. So why would I, you know, just shut up and accept whatever it's being said? Now, I need to do some work of self-knowledge and work on myself to be able to discern where do those reactions come from. But what I can be sure of is that whenever I'm reacting to something, I'm losing control and I'm not exercising my personal responsibility. So that's going to affect also accountability and integrity. If I don't make myself accountable for my actions and my omissions, both, I'm losing an opportunity. Again, I'm losing an opportunity of growth. I'm just going to keep on repeating that mistake until I decide to make myself accountable. And integrity, because let's say when we are on a job, just as an example, the fact that we are able to accept our mistakes and be accountable for them, it it passes on this energy and this idea that we have integrity. And that's something very valuable also, not only in our work, but on our day-to-day life. And as I said, these studies have proven that being accountable and taking ownership of your actions and not just giving that responsibility to someone else, not passing that responsibility into someone else or into something, it improves mental health and well-being. And also, it's a crucial point when we are trying to fight any kind of addiction. And we all have addictions, you know, whether big or small, whether more socially accepted or not, we all have addictions and we all have to work on those. And some of them are really painful to each one of us. And sometimes, you know, we keep on thinking, oh, I have to change this. I have to stop acting like this or doing this or not doing this. And by blaming ourselves, we keep on putting that hard energy, that that weight on ourselves, that makes it even more difficult to get out of that situation. So again, the only way to start coming out of those addictions is taking personal responsibility. Now, in Spiritism, we find, as I said, in different books, this idea that each person is responsible for their own spiritual progress and that our actions have consequences. Whatever we do is going to have a consequence, and it's going to depend on us. Whatever I do, it's going to depend on me. Now, it's going to have consequences now and in the so-called afterlife. So it's the same life. When we die, we keep, we were studying that today in our mediumship development group. When we die, we're gonna keep our individuality. We're gonna keep on being ourselves. Nothing is going to change. If I'm not, if I didn't work on developing my personal responsibility, on accepting that responsibility for the things I do every day, if I carry that, I'm going to have that, and I'm going to have to fight that, let's say, at the other side. I will keep, and then it's going to be even more difficult because I'm not going to have the help of the material that I have here. So that's why it makes it even more important to work on this now. Now, through the exercise of personal responsibility, we have the capacity of the power to transform our lives, because that exercise of personal responsibility, it's going to help on our self-improvement and our spiritual development. And that's basically taking responsibility for our own evolution. And we were talking about that today too. Do I think about my own evolution? Do I have a plan? How do I approach that? Because we have plans for many things, many material things mainly, but do we have a plan for how do I exercise this responsibility, which is not mine, which is not of the center or any church or anywhere that you may go to. Nobody has the responsibility for your spiritual evolution. You do, and I do, for not by coming here and listening to you talk for, you know, sometime a week. That's going to happen. We need a plan. And personal responsibility, as we saw there, as this notion of action, taking action. So it is also very good because it helps us exercising personal responsibility. It will help us to set goals and take action towards those goals. So when we're talking about spiritual evolution, it is going to help us to set our goals and take the action that we need to take towards those. Thank you. So when understanding the power of personal responsibility, these are just some examples. We talked about some of these, like taking ownership, admitting mistakes, being accountable, and setting objectives. These are some examples of the power that personal responsibility has. And it's going to empower us, this exercise, as I was just saying, by the ability to achieve goals. So this is the ability to succeed. And if we're talking about spiritual evolution, the ability to achieve that, to get somewhere in that respect. Because it's very easy when we don't set goals that things just keep on escaping. And then we may look back at some point and say, ooh, now what? And that's also one exercise that is good to do. Resilience, it's also something that we can exercise by taking responsibility. When we fight, or when we set our own responsibility about anything that is happening to us in our life, and we externalize it, we give it to someone or to any situation, we're going to repeat that. And whenever we experience a conflict or a setback, we're going to suffer with that. Because not taking ownership of it is just going to, again, put friction in the system and make us suffer. If we do, if we take responsibility, if we don't put those things in the hands of others or of something, we are exercising that resilience. And then whenever another situation happens, the way we're going to approach it, it's going to be much lighter. We're going to suffer less or not suffer with that situation if we have exercise this personal responsibility, this taking ownership of things. And it's going to help us with self-awareness as well. Now, it's important when we're talking about personal responsibility to be aware of the impact that things that we do, the actions that we take, or the inaction that we sometimes do, have on others. Sometimes, maybe our words, maybe we think we're just joking with someone. We say something like, you better not sing because it's not going to stop raining, or it could be something stupid like that. It may have an impact on that person. And that's also another example of how personal responsibility can make us being accountable for actions and decisions. Many. Thanks. Okay. So this is a very crucial part on the idea of personal responsibility, because we are, I think, well, at least I talk for myself, I'm so accustomed to put blame on things, then we lose sight of how powerful and how important and how things change for me if I take personal responsibility for things. So when I put blame, basically I'm working from a point of fear. I'm trying to defend myself from something that typically is imaginary. Some problem, some issue, some, again, maybe a status or a position that I think I've gained, or a right to something, or maybe I've worked for something and then I thought I developed a right to earn, whether it's something material or a title or a position. And I work from that position of fear if I try to put the blame for anything that goes wrong or that does not go according to my expectations. I try to put it on something or on someone. And what this means is that, again, no matter what happened, there's no exception to this. There's no, oh, there's nothing I can do about this, or this is very unjust. That's something that we commonly say, oh, this is very unjust. I've been treated unjustly. They are giving this other person what they're not giving me. We've talked about different situations here other times. Like, you know, it's like even like having a passport from a country and versus someone that does not have it. It just puts you in a different situation. And you may feel, well, you know, I'm being mistreated. Or and you may be right that many situations we could say they are not just. But again, in any situation, with no exception, you can take responsibility for the part that belongs to you, which is what you do with whatever is happening to you. And trying not to react to that, trying to build whatever it's possible, whatever thing is best. And that puts you in a position of courage. That puts you in a positive position. So you come out of this, oh, this is happening to me, what am I gonna do? You're on a place of negative energy to put you just with the same situation, fighting the same thing with maybe materially, with lack of things that you may have, it puts you on a better place. If only for something selfish, you should be doing this, because it's, you know, it's much better to be in this position of courage than a position of fear. Now, when we put blame on others, on things, we tend to hold the grudges. And when we're holding grudges, again, this is a question of energy. We are building this energy, which is going to get us sick. Sooner or later, we're going to develop some kind of pain, physical pain, some kind of illness from this holding grudges. It's psychosomatic. Yeah, it starts at an emotional level, and with time, it's going to pass onto our body. And again, same situation. Don't change. Take whatever example you want from your life and put yourself into the side of accepting responsibility instead of outsourcing the blame. And then you are in that place when you where you forgive and you let go. And when we are in the position of I have a right to this, this is the way things should be. Why should this person be better considered than myself when I've worked more? Name it. Just pick whatever of those or any others you thought about today. To come here and to say, I let go. It's okay. I don't need to be this or that. I don't need to have this or that. I need to be considered in this position, or maybe I did something for someone. Maybe the simplest of things. I've done something, and for what I did, it's okay. I did it. I did my best in this situation, and I'm okay with that. I let go of whatever it is. If there is, you know, if it comes and says thank you, or I'm being recognized, or whatever it is, that's going to be. Don't move too much, right? That's going to be a. Going to be a byproduct of that action that I did. But I should not be expecting that. And moving from here to there, it's really difficult. But it's really good. So you can start by trying with something small. Because only by practicing, first by being aware of it, by being aware that I'm holding this grudge, or that I'm I'm experiencing fear in respect to any situation or relationship or conflict. Only by being aware, I can start to move to this side. And it's, again, I say it's very difficult. I say that in my own experience, because for me, takes a lot to say, okay, I let go. It's okay. I'm good with myself. What I need is to believe in myself. What I need is to believe in my abilities, in my resources, in what I'm capable of being and doing. And that's really all I need. That is difficult. But whenever I've managed to succeed on that, it's been amazing. And that's a process of taking personal responsibility. Because if we say it like that, if we say, oh, do we take personal responsibility? Probably most of us will answer, yeah. Yeah, I'm responsible for what I do. I own my things. But when we start thinking about our day-to-day and the little things, then we start seeing that we're more here than here, and that coming from here to here, it's tough. But it's possible. Now, when we are in the blame state, we stay stuck in the past. And it's just like a heavy weight to move if we want to move forward. And that's what we manage when we move into the responsibility side. Another question is understanding human nature. We're not perfect. And many times we believe we are, and everybody else should be too. And we put blame on ourselves, and we put blame on others, because we don't understand that we're fallible. We may be doing our best, and it may not be good. But it's our best, and that's what taking responsibility is, doing our best. So we should not be expecting perfection. And that's it says expecting. It's not expecting perfection. When we blame, we keep on living either in the past or in the future. Why was it like this? It should not be like this, or there's no way we're gonna move on, there's no way we're gonna fix the situation, there's no solution for this. This is the place of blame and not taking responsibility. When we take responsibility, we're living in the present, which is the only place where we can do anything. And taking responsibility is about taking action. It's taking action towards our goals. And the only place where you can take action is right now, is the present moment. It's not thinking about why did I do, or didn't I do, or did they do, or didn't they do, or there's no way to solve this, I'm not going to be able to. That is not going to help. The only thing that's going to help is right here and right now. And that's taking responsibility. Now, I wanted to bring Manny. They're chatting like very lively there, not taking responsibility for the talk. Indeed, they are not. So, yeah, thank you. One example that I wanted to bring from the Spirit's book about this, and again, if you go into it, there's a whole section on fate and fatalism and free will, which is really, really interesting to go deeper on this. But I just wanted to bring this question. Do social customs often force people to follow one road rather than another? And is their choice of occupation often controlled by the opinion of those around them? So why I brought this is because we're very used to saying, oh, this is the way society functions. This is the way the center functions. This is the way things have been done for 150 years. This is culturally accepted or not accepted. So already 150 years ago, more, when Kardec put together the answers from the spirits, if you read there, they were saying that none of that. We remain in control of our free will to say, this is the way I'm going to do, this is the way I'm going to take my responsibility and act and take action. And I don't need to be, I don't need to outsource my own responsibility and my own decisions and what I do to society or culture or my childhood or anything. Of course, that's part of me. And that's part of what, you know, those inputs that we were talking about. But the output, that's completely up to me. And they were already saying that 160-some years ago. Now, to finish, I just want to go over a bucket list, right? Thank you. A bucket list of how to overcome the obstacles that we find to be able to move from here, from this point of blame, to this point of taking responsibility. And you see that there's four of them up there, which I just want to highlight. And those four, does anybody recognize those? Yes? The four agreements, thank you. So those are exactly the four agreements. It's a book by Don Miguel Ruiz. If you have not read that book, it's a must read or even a must study book. And I find that those four agreements in the book, Miguel Ruiz, he explains how those four actions can help you live a much better life, a fulfilled life. They can help you to grow and let go and get rid of many things, many conflicts, and get rid of much of that resistance and suffering that we put into the process of our own life, of our own evolution. So that's why I wanted to bring those four first of the 10 points of the bucket list. The first one is to be impeccable with our word. And what that means, first of all, word, it means that words have power. Words have a tremendous power. So we, you know, we may be gossiping, or of course we don't. Nobody here does that. No, you know, we just make comments that are intended to better things. But in reality, we're judging, and we're using words to judge others. to comment about what others do or don't do. And we're using that word and we're using that power in something that it's not constructive. It's not constructive for anybody else, but it's not constructive for myself, first of all. Now, if I see something that I don't like, if I see something that looks ugly to me, if I see a situation that could be made better, don't say a word. Just do whatever you think can be useful. Just do whatever you think can be constructive. And again, your energy is not going to suffer from that. You're not going to carry this negative energy, because words carry a lot of power and they carry a lot of weight. And basically what he's saying is that we should be speaking with integrity, and we should only be saying the things that we really mean. How many times we catch ourselves saying things and then, I didn't mean that. Well, again, that's not taking responsibility. That's, you know, putting blame on things. Our mind, it's like a fertile land where, you know, you plant a seed and it grows. You put a word there and it grows. And we have, you know, many examples from even children where you know, one day you tell them something that for you it's trivial, or maybe you have a bad day and you speak badly to a child about something they were doing. That may stay with them. They may grow and they may believe that they are not maybe capable to do something just because that day you didn't have a good day and you said, you know, don't do that. It's bothering me right now, or you're very bad at that, or, you know, whatever it is. So be impeccable means, in the words of Miguel Ruiz, it means without sin. And sin to him in this context is anything that can hurt me. So being impeccable with my word is be really mindful of how I use my words. And of course, my words are connected to my thoughts. And what am I thinking? How am I, again, am I reacting to things? Or am I taking responsibility for what's happening to me? So this is the first point. The second one is don't take anything personally. And this is, yeah, a tough one I'm hearing here. It is tough, but it is so rewarding. It's so rewarding once you start not taking this personally. Just someone saying, oh, you really screwed up on that situation. Or you're no good, you're useless. This or that, because you made us all fail in this project. It doesn't matter, you know, and you feel like this person is that's envy of me or something that, you know, you're feeling at that moment. Probably is none of that. More than likely, that person, whatever someone is saying to you, it reflects what's with them, not what's with you. And to make that shift.
Not exactly take it as a personal, like, oh, this person doesn't like him, not like him, sure, like that, but say, yeah, exactly, something that I need to grow in using these experiences to grow.
Yeah, no, that's exactly it. Learning. Taking responsibility for things, it's a learning process as well. So you learn what you need to you. Again, it's always you. I learned what I need to change. I learned what I need to do better. I learned what I can do different. I learned how can I engage with the situation in a way that it's better for me, that it helps me grow, that it makes me suffer less. And that may be any of the things that we said, maybe letting go, or it may be setting boundaries. It's not necessarily, I'm not saying, oh, just, you know, drop dead and let everybody step all over you. That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying take responsibility. And if that means setting boundaries, that's what you have to do, whatever it is in the situation. But it's not saying, oh, you have to change that. You have to change the way you do things. That's not taking responsibility. Even if you think that by that person changing, the project is going to succeed, or there's going to be a better harmony in the group, or it's not up to you. That is not your place. That is not your responsibility. That's going to make you suffer if you try to change someone. So don't take anything personal. Again, it may seem hard, but once you start practicing that, it's so rewarding. It's so good. If you were only to take one of them, the 10 things here, to me, I have started with this, and I really recommend, because the outcome, the effects that you get from that are so good. Don't make assumptions. This is very important too. When again, when you have any situation, relationship, conflict, we tend to make assumptions. We tend to think, oh, this person has ill will towards me, or doesn't like me, or has envy of me, and that's why this person is acting this way. Or, oh, I did something a few months ago, and that's why this person is not responding. Or simply, maybe with someone at home, we don't get a response to a phone or message for, say, 5 hours, and we start assuming the worst, and we start creating that bad energy. It just leads to more conflict, and it just leads to more problems. And again, it's avoiding taking responsibility for our things. So instead of making assumptions, ask questions. That's like one simple thing, that we can do. Don't assume that you know, even if you believe to your core that you know. Ask questions, always. And even if you get the answers, ask more questions to be sure of the things. But we tend to assume. And we tend to think that everybody sees the world through the same kind of lenses that I see the world. So that's an assumption. And that's one that we make very often, because we are trained to think like that. At least some of us, maybe not all, but some of us, we're trained to do that, and we do it very well. So to move to that space where we don't make assumptions and we start asking questions, again, it's not easy, and it requires awareness. It requires to be aware that, oh, maybe I'm assuming, and or asking the question, is there any other possibility? Is this the only possibility? Could it be different, even if I don't see it? Is there a possibility that this is different? The answer is always yes. It's always yes. So look for it. Look for that. And always do your best. Again, we're not perfect, and we have days, and better days, and worse days, and our best may not even be good at some point. It may be good, but it may not be good, and that's okay. If you do our best, you're going to get there, and you're going to end up taking responsibility for your things, because it means exactly the same thing. Doing my best and taking responsibility, it means exactly the same thing. And I was, while preparing this, I was listening to someone who put the example of Forrest Gump, the movie, and the character. And this character, he was a simple person, no studies, no apparent deep culture or anything. And being this simple person had one characteristic. He always did his best. Always, in any situation. So life brought him these amazing experiences because he was always doing his best, no matter what happened. If you've seen the movie, probably everybody has seen that movie. He went through through hell sometimes. Didn't lose faith. Just kept going, kept doing his best. And maybe you've taken a picture of this or not. I don't know. I'm saying this because it's 9:10 and I'm not going to go over everything else. But if you want to, you have a bucket list here and you have some things that you can refer to in order to work on that process. Because like anything else, taking responsibility, it's a process. And it's not something that we are going to achieve from one day to the next. But if we have a plan, if we craft that plan, and if we try to do our best always, we'll get there. We'll get to be responsible for ourselves. And that's my message for today. Thank you.